Previously, we discussed about that J transforms, that is x of z is equals to, we have taken J transform of that sequence that is in a discrete time signal, that is x of n. Now I want the x of n from your Z domain function, that is by taking the inverse J transform of the given Z domain function, and similarly like in Laplace and frequency domain, that is it implies x of n is equals to 1 by Z, that is Z inverse. So Z inverse of your Z domain function. So now you want the x of n here, that is inverse J transform of the your Z domain function. There are four methods that are used to describe the, that are used to find the inverse J transform of the given Z domain function. So that is the first method, long division method. Long division method, and this is also called as a power series method. Yesterday we told, discussed the problems. And second one, convolution method. By using convolution property, we are finding the sequence, that is a discrete time sequence, applying to the inverse of the given Z domain function. And third one is partial fraction expansion method. The fourth one is residues method. Residues method. So now we'll go for the convolution method. So note down one problem. Find the inverse J transform of the, find the inverse Z transform of the following Z domain function. Following Z domain function, x of z equal to z square by z plus 1 into z plus 2. ROC is mod z greater than 2. So I mentioned here ROCs. ROC is mod z greater than 2 means the sequence is right side or left sided? Right sided. That you know, by seeing this one, easily we are obtaining that one. Right. So by using convolution method, this one, you have to. What is your question? Find the inverse Z transform of the following sequence, following Z domain function using convolution method. So what is the property for 424? Convolution property in Z transform. So that already you know the Laplace and similarly Fourier and similarly Z transform. The convolution of the two sequences, any two sequences that are in discrete time, is equal to product of their individual J transform. That is your convolution property. If you are taking vice versa, like inverse of multiplication of your individual J transforms is equal to convoluting of your two sequences. That is your convolution in inverse J transform, vice versa. So now you can split into this function as two functions, like x of z equal to, I am writing this one, z by z plus 1 into z by z plus 2. Any problem? No problem. Why? I am splitting as two functions, like x1 of z into x2 of z, that is equal to x of z. When multiplying these two functions, z into z, z square, as it is numerator, like denominators here, z plus 1 into z plus 2, plus 2. Let us consider this one, x1 of z and x2 of z. So now you see this is looking like your convolution property in inverse z transform, like multiplication of their individual z transform is equal to convoluting of your discrete time sequences. So now you want x of n, like x1 of n. So you know x1 of z. If you know x1 of z, you will get easily by using standard functions or properties, you will get x1 of n. That is inverse of x1 of z is called as x1 of n. So by inverse z transform formula, x1 of n equal to z inverse of x1 of z, like this. So now this is x1 of z and this is x2 of z. So now you want x1 of n. X1 of n equal to z inverse of, what is this one? Z by z plus 1. So you know one property, standard function. Z transform of the a power n into u of n. Anybody? A power n into u of n. Z by z minus a into ROC is your that, you know, mod z greater than. So that is the right side sequence they gave here, right side. Right. So inverse of u1. So z inverse of z by z minus a is equal to vice versa, a to the power of n into u of n, that is. So what is a here by comparing these two functions? A equal to minus 1, minus of minus 1 you can write. So now you can write x1 of n equal to, what is that one? Minus 1 whole to the power of n into u of n. This is your discrete time sequence of x1 of z by taking inverse of your z domain function by using standard properties or standard functions. And similarly, so what is x2 of n? X2 of n equal to z inverse of x2 of z is z by z plus 2, right? So what is a here? Minus 2. By using again similarly same property, this one minus 2 what to the power of n into u of n. Now you got the two sequences that are in discrete time signals, right? So what is the property here? By using convolution property, so inverse z transform of the multiplication of two individual z transforms equal to convoluting of two sequences, that is x1 of n convoluting of x2 of n. So now you can write here by using convoluting property, that is inverse of x1 of z into x2 of z. I'm writing here by implies of this one, that is x1 of n convoluting of x2 of n. You know x1 of n and x2 of n. By using this property we are finding the sequence, that is x of n, that x of n equal to this entire sequence convoluting of two sequences. Therefore x1 of n convoluting of x2 of n is equal to, so what is x1 of n? This one minus 1 what to the power of n into u of n convoluting with one more sequence, that is minus 2 what to the power of n into u of n. But you know one property, convolution formula, f1 of t convoluting of f2 of t equal to integration of f1 of tau into f2 of t minus tau with respect to tau variable. Whereas in continuous case, whereas in discrete case, summation we are taking, right? By taking the summation operator, we are writing. So that is the formula here, x1 of n convolution of x2 of n equal to summation of, you can take the new variable here. Your variable is n, that is a discrete time variable, independent variable. Now I am taking converting into another variable, that is a k. So k equal to 0 to n, x1 of k, x2 of n minus k you can write. Otherwise, x2 of k into x1 of n minus k. That is a convolution formula in continuous case as well as discrete case. Continuous case we are taking integration, that is it contains infinite number of rational and irrational numbers. Whereas in discrete means summation, that is a countable and finite. That is in discrete case. So by taking the same thing as, this is your x1 of n, this is your x2 of n signal. So by taking convolution of the two. Therefore, so what is that one? Minus 1 over to the power of k. So now we can take summation of k equal to 0 to n, minus 1 over to the power of k into u of n, that is u of k into second one minus 1, minus 2 over to the power of n minus k, like the same second signal, that is second sequence, into u of n minus k. So you know the condition, this one u of n condition and u of n minus k, that are your unit step functions in discrete case. So what is u of n equal to condition? That is condition, unit step signal condition, u of n equal to 1 when n greater than or equal to 0, otherwise condition 0. Whereas in the similarly continuous case, similarly same, but time is different, that is a continuous time, here discrete time. And this is also similarly shifted unit step function, u of n minus k equal to 1 when n greater than or equal to k, otherwise condition 0, that is the condition. So by taking these two things, we are writing this one, summation k equal to 0 to n, minus 1 over to the power of k, minus 2 over to the power of n into minus 2 over to the power of k, I am writing, minus k I am writing. Thus u of n equal to 1 and u of n minus k equal to 1 I am taking, right? So in this, minus 2 over to the power of n is constant. Why? This n is not independent variable here, that is different, some arbitrary variable, right? We are converting into k variable, right? K is independent variable now, when I am convoluting with these two sequences, like x1 of n convoluting with x2 of n, right? That is x of n. So now we can write this one out of this summation operator, right? That is a minus 2 over to the power of n, that is minus 2 over to the power of n, the summation k equal to 0 to n, remaining is minus 1 over to the power of k, minus 2 over to the power of minus k. Like x power minus 1 means you can write 1 by x, like by minus 2 over to the power of k, a to the power of m by b to the power of m, a by b whole to the power of m, like that you can write this one. That is minus 2 whole to the power of m, a summation here, k equal to 0 to n, minus 1 by minus 2 whole to the power of k, that is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is a 0.5, that is a minus 2 whole to the power of n into summation k equal to 0 to n, 0.5 whole to the power of k. That is your x of n sequence. That is inverse Z transform the your Z domain signal by using convolution method. Like this is important question for external examination, right? It's not it this one. Any doubt?